November is being observed as Tourism Awareness Month in Guyana. Here is a special feature on Guyana's only Maroon settlement, Barakara. Ranetta Court reports.
If you are looking for an affordable tourist destination, why not consider Barakara? Fun fact, Barakara is the only Maroon village in Guyana. A group of escaped slaves settled in Barakara in the early 19th century and occupied both the east and west banks of the river. The Maroon community, also known as Nugrung Village or Welty Vreeden, can be found in the East Berbice Quarantine region, 75 miles from the town of New Amsterdam and just north of the Turani Canal. During a recent visit to the community, Channel 8 News spoke with Conroy LaFleur, who has resided in the area for over 28 years, and he highlighted that life in Barakara is all about contentment.
Life in Barakara, it's golden and it's a little tight sometimes, because right now with the dry, right now we're enjoying it. But when the rain fall and the place flood out, you know, some people get diarrhea and all kind of things, so it's a little tough on us. But right now, life is good because we contented people.
He also boasted of the friendly and close-knit relationship of the people in Barakara.
Actually, everybody, if you check if you do a survey in the community, you will just find about seven type of the LaFleur, the Amsterdam a lot, the Adams, the Young. We tie up to each other, man. Everybody in here is actually family.
The community has certain public facilities such as the healthcare center, the school, and a resource center located on the western bank of the Kanji River. When asked why persons should consider a trip to Barakara, Conroy gave these comments.
This is part of Guyana, and I think the people here, I know the people here are very, they have a very good hospitality. The breeze that blow with the trees show that life is good, you know, you're just enjoying God through nature. And it's a fast different place from out on the road. You know, the road you see vehicle like car and buses and those things, but in here we have boat and paddle boat and engine, that is our vehicle or means of transportation.
On the eastern side of the river, you can find two recreational grounds, two liquor stores, six shops, and the Scottish Presbyterian, Adventist, and Pentecostal churches. Conroy also noted that if you ever visited the Adventist church, you are sure to hear music from The Revelations, a singing group he is a part of. This newscast also had the opportunity to speak with leader of the group, Mr. Marshall Thompson, who gave a brief background of the group, after which they gave a rendition of one of their favorite songs.
I'm a part of a very vibrant singing group named The Revolution. We actually started around 6 years now. It was through myself, the lead fellow on the floor, and born in Amsterdam. But then we extend the group to 12 persons, which we are doing fairly all right. We really enjoy life, being together as a singing group.
But he rescued me, my Jesus rescued me from the cold of water, from sin, struggle, sea. He rescued me.
The main economic activity for residents is small and large-scale farming, including cattle rearing and logging. However, there are a few residents who engage in fishing, bird catching, and hunting. In terms of leisure and entertainment, the entire community would gather at the community ground and have a good time cooking and sharing with each other.
If you check on a Sunday, the whole community will turn out on the church ground and we will play volleyball, cricket. We have fun together. That is our fun day. On a Sunday afternoon, it's like a big sport day in the community. Everybody turn out like a village day. We have snacks on sales and everybody just having a nice time. We're playing hopscotch, somebody playing domino, cricket, volleyball. We just enjoy ourselves, man.
So the next time you're looking for a place to explore, visit Barakara, Guyana's only maroon settlement. Reporting for Channel 8 News, Renetta Court.